Well, talk about this old late model world a little bit. It's went through some changes, a lot of them, if you consider how far back you want to go. But even recently, you know, it seems like the chassis manufacturers have become a real big thing. Shocks, packages. You ain't necessarily got to develop it in the shop. You can just buy a set. You know, what's your opinion on how the sports kind of went, or where it's at?
Well, I don't know. It's what you said is true. You know, you can just buy the stuff now, and it gets, you know, shows up at your shop, you know, already ready to bolt on the car. Way different from the old days. You know, a lot of people like that. I think the old school guys like myself probably don't like it as much, because we just like to figure it out on our own and you know, and go on with it. But nowadays, it just all the technology stuff can be bought, I guess. And you know, just you know, the sport, I don't know, there's so many things they could do rule wise do, I think, you know, cut cost on things. And you know, I think you just kind of need to slow the cars down and make them handle more illy, you know, to where the driver's got to drive it more than today. They're just so aerodynamic dependent and just glued down to the racetrack that, you know, I think it makes it harder to pass that way. Yeah, that's my opinion. I think some other guys would agree with me. You know, they're just so fast, like sprint cars. You know, that, you know, with wings on them, you know, they're just in the earth so good that
the track has to go away to have a decent race.
They don't slip and slide much anymore. I mean, even when the track goes away, you know, you adjust this, adjust that. But, you know, they're still
well. And traditionally, they would say slick the track off for good racing, but it seems like the technology now is more suitable for the slick. So it's like the track goes away, but the technology is that's when it shines, especially on the late models.
Yeah, but you know, the racing, I think, still even today is better when the track slows down than, you know, when it's wide open fast. You know, I just think the racing's better with a little bit slower speed. And you know, I watched all that Bristol stuff over there last weekend, or the last couple of weeks, when they ran our kind of cars there, and then they run the Cup cars there, and the Cup cars were, you know, 5 seconds slower than our car ran around in these cars.
Well, that's because these are real man race cars.
Yeah, well, but I know 5 seconds, but I will, the racing they had was almost better than our racing, I thought. You know, they were slower, but when you get slower and the cars don't handle around the bottom so well, you can run that outside until the track kind of went away on the outside, you know. But what I watched, both Bristol races for these kind of cars, you know, the World Outlaws and the one before, and in my opinion, there wasn't a whole lot of passing going on. Everybody, you know, just kind of ran around the bottom, and they're glued down around the bottom, and the guy on the outside can't really keep up any out there.
Well, at the Bristol Dirt Nationals, Davenport did go to the top and drive to the front around him, but it seemed like you had to have it set right.
Yeah, well, he was, you know, the race he won, he did a heck of a job, you know, but he beat them all on tires too, you know. He had different tires on than the rest of the guys had, and the last 10 laps when they were all fading, he got stronger, you know.
Now, the tire deal with this MLRA is a little different. Can you talk about that or anything like that? They got it. You have to have the 4-set tires or something like that?
Yeah, they're making you mark your 4 tires, and you got to run them all night till the main event. Then you can put 2 new rear ones on, I guess, is their rule. You know, they're trying to help maybe save money. I don't think it does. I don't agree with that rule myself, but, you know, I don't make the rules. But they think it saves money, but, like, I don't. I got new tires, I got used tires, you know, and I kind of do it by how I'm running that night. You know, if I qualify real well, you know, I'm going to have my best stuff on to run the heat race, whatever. But, you know, if I have a run third or fourth in the heat and I'm starting back in the main event, or if I, you know, in the heat race even, sometimes, you know, I'll put a used tire on rather than a new tire on, you know, and just to save the new tire for when I'm having a better day type thing, you know. And when you're married to the same 4 tires all night, you know, naturally everybody's going to put brand new ones on at the, you know, every night. And myself, I wouldn't necessarily put 4 brand new ones on every night, you know. So I'm sure other people would disagree. Some people agree, you know, but with what I just said. But, you know, I don't make the rules. Just got to kind of do what they say.
Yeah, it seems like it's tough to compete nowadays too, just because everything's so even.
Yeah, I mean, everybody nowadays, yeah, the stopwatch, everybody is closer together, where, you know, if your next door neighbor's putting new tires on, you have to too, you know. You're only an eyelash apart from one another. If that new tire is a shade quicker, you know, you about got to have it on there. So it's kind of, you know, the tires, I don't know, I just kind of made it.
A lot of debates in the late model world, for sure.